Hello everyone, hope you're having a lovely day so far. My name is Juliana in English and Juliana in Español, and welcome to the Going Global podcast. Alejandra Molina is a Peruvian entrepreneur who speaks four languages and has lived in at least 14 countries before settling in New York and making her mark in the business world. She is also an LIU Global alumna who graduated from the program in May 2019. She is the co-founder and director of marketing at Beep Boop, an all-online learning platform which teaches students Spanish through 25-minute audio-only group lessons, which focus on speech and are taught by a live instructor. I would love to ask you a little bit about the background of creating Beep Boop and like how did this idea started, what was the process of creating it like, and then why did you choose the name Beep Boop? I'm really curious about that and what your main goal was in the developing of Beep Boop.
Absolutely. First of all, I want to say thank you for inviting me to the podcast. I'm super happy to be here and share my experiences with all the LIU Global community as well as like the audience here. So yeah, how did I came up with the idea to create ebook? So throughout my years, I have always been taught that like you need to learn English, like you get more opportunities doing that. But the more languages that I was untapping into, the better opportunities that I was getting. And I realized that many doors were opening up for me. So realizing that languages was gonna help me be a more well-rounded global citizen really pushed me to realize that, oh, like language learning should be something that should be easy. And I realized that all these methods that were existing out there, like AI was not personally doesn't connect you to human beings. So like, if you want to be understood in a foreign language, a machine is not going to, it's not going to determine what you're going to be understood or not. It's a human being. So they lack that human aspect. And then these amazing methods, like the one that we were immersed into with LIU Global or the ones from Dartmouth College that has this system, it's all for people that have the resources to go and travel to another country or be in these elite institutions and get access to this method. So I realized that amazing methods for learning languages were not accessible. And what we were trying to do with Beboop is to expand that accessibility. We focus on audio only, and that's why, because we really want to get this method and platform to be available for as many people as possible, regardless of your zip code, regardless of your bandwidth, your internet bandwidth. So with making it audio only, we realized that more people in other countries that don't have such great internet access could participate in the classes, could benefit from this amazing platform and method that we have. And then I met last year during a startup weekend event from Techstars here in New York City, my co-founder, and we both pitched language learning ideas. And he was like, he already had this amazing idea of like utilizing this inspiration that he got from his years in Dartmouth College. And then we both were like, yeah, I got the experience of being immersed in the country, but not a lot of people have access to that. And he realized same, like Ivy Leagues are not as accessible as they could be. And so we both were like, let's expand accessibility to this amazing method. So we created Beboop last year during the summer. Our first product was launched in September of 2019. So that was like after a few months of graduating college. And the reason why we chose the name Beboop is because we had previously another name that was not as easy to remember. And then when we were correcting our students during our online classes, our online drills, we call that every Beboop class is called drill. We realized that students were feeling kind of weird when you said like wrong, and it sounded very aggressive and intimidating. So we looked up words that will make people feel comfortable and will make them laugh. And some of the words that we found out there was Beboop, that you cannot say without smiling. And that's why we call it Beboop, because now every time you're in the platform, in the classroom, in the drill, the teacher, if you make a pronunciation mistake, so let's say you're reading a word and you say it wrong, the teacher will say Beboop, and then she'll correct you. And it's a fun way. It makes it kind of like, it's like a mocking way, because it's humans that are making robot sounds. And it's also kind of like emphasizing the fact that humans are sometimes are better at teaching you languages, because you want to be understood by humans, and who better to tell you if you're speaking correctly than a human being. And yeah, that was my main goal when developing the app, is to break down language barriers, making language learning accessible, expanding it so that more people can converse in a foreign language, as well as just for the medical Spanish aspect, which was our first product, is to help Spanish-speaking patients in the U.S. get the most optimal services from healthcare providers here, and just like breaking down those inequalities in healthcare, which are more latent nowadays with the pandemic.
Right, of course. No, and that's so important. And I wanted to ask you about that. So I know it's BPOOP has been really helpful for physicians in the health sector. And I kind of wanted to ask you what difference you think it has made so far. And if you could talk a little bit about the importance of accessibility to minorities in healthcare and how healthcare might not be as equitable right now and how we can make that better.
So with BPOOP, we've been able to teach healthcare professionals the most critical phrases they need to know to treat Spanish-speaking patients. And this is a disclaimer. Everyone says like, oh, you need a translator and everything. Yeah, but for these kind of conversations that are, for example, you take some time and you ask your patient, how are you doing? Is your back hurting? And that's not involving anything. You just want to have a small talk so that your patient can trust you more. Those conversations don't happen as often when this patient that you have doesn't speak the same language as you. So we received reviews, and you can see that on our website, from healthcare professionals that have used our platform. And after a few months, they've been able to feel more comfortable. They've been able to converse with their patients, establish a strong connection. And that has been proven by different studies by Harvard and Duke that improves the healthcare outcomes from their patients. So establishing a good relationship with your patient is going to have good healthcare outcomes.
I am so glad that BPOOP exists, because that is so true. Just having that personal connection can make a big difference. I kind of wanted to ask you about how BPOOP approaches like language learning. I know you talked about the drills, which are 25 minutes. So why did you decide to structure the lessons the way that you did? And can you please like describe how a typical lesson would go?
So the reason why we did it in 25 minutes is because we understand that healthcare providers don't have a lot of free time. They're always on the call. And now with the pandemic, their work time, it's blurry. You know, they have to work so many hours, and 25 minutes is digestible. Then when you join a class, the thing that happens, we call them BPOOP drills. And BPOOP drills are 25-minute sessions in which you have the drill instructor, which are one of our 13 Mexico-based drill instructors, and that's going to be teaching the class live. And you are guided through a series of speaking activities that help you work your muscle memory. So I like to describe it sometimes as like making your brain learn a new choreography, because, you know, when you're learning a new dance choreography, you're like, follow the teacher with the same steps. And then when the more steps you know, the better you can create your own choreographies. So it's the same way we're doing with BPOOP. We help you with your speaking proficiency, your listening proficiency, as well as your reading. And we also are very critical in correction of the pronunciation and the accent. So with us, you're going to sound like a native as soon as we finish the classes, in these words that we're teaching you, or phrases that we're teaching you. We realize, and this is something very important, is that the first thing that someone can test to see how good you are in a language is by speaking it. And it's going to open you way many more doors than just knowing how to write and read. It's about speaking. And when you're treating a patient, you don't have that much time to write down things. So the more you can understand, the more you're put in that setting. So our classes are also going to guide you to certain virtual simulations of scenarios in which you have a patient and they ask you certain questions, and then you're going to have to repeat that question. And it's all like our method. It's like putting you at the edge of your seat and guiding you. And that's why it's also tied into our mascot, which is Taka de Coca. And they're a coach. It's like your mom. It's like a coach is trying to help you perfect your pronunciation at the same time, giving you real feedback, honest feedback. And you get, after a 25-minute drill session, you get your feedback report. It's called a report card, in which you can see which are the words that you need to practice, how you did with pronunciation, how you did with the also memory retention. And then we send you some specific feedback if you're a VIP student. So we are a freemium program. We offer free classes for anyone that you can take it. We have classes starting every 30 minutes. So right now, if you're listening, you can literally go to bwoop.us and go to the website and register for a class that's happening, let's say 10 minutes. Nice. And you'll participate in the classroom. Then after, you'll receive your feedback. And if you're a VIP, you can also have access to all our complimentary features, such as like flashcards. We also give you access to quizzes, as well as unit sections. You can be part of our social learning group community online. Now that COVID is happening, it's really hard to connect with people offline. So yeah, it's a holistic approach to learning languages.
I love that. And I love that you mentioned that at the end, the holistic approach, because that is so important. Just knowing grammar is not enough. It's the conversation and the speaking that really makes you understand and learn. And I was just really curious to see you being a polyglot, is that if that's the same approach you took to language learning, and how did your own language learning influence in the making of Beep Boop?
Yeah, so the thing that influenced it the most was my co-founder's experience of learning Japanese in Dartmouth College and taking these classes at the Russia Center, which is a very dynamic way of learning languages. It's like, it's you are asked, like, for example, right now I'll ask you to repeat a sentence, and it's like, I'll say your name like really fast and things like that. And I'm assuming also the fact that I like that we put you in situations and we don't let you have that much time to think about translating. It is just about feeling the language. And that's something that happened to me through my high school years. I was put in a high school that was international. So we had classes in English, and I was not taught like the background so much at the beginning. It was more about like, I was learning math in English, and I had like 5 seconds. A teacher would ask me a question, and I didn't have time to think about the translation. I had to remember words that she used to answer that question. So the same thing we do at BeBook. We complement it also with the visualization that we use. So you'll see our modules has different sites with pictures as well as the phrases. And we'll also, the fact that you have that human being that's helping you, that's also really useful, which the AI apps don't have, like Duolingo, where like a compliment, we will also give you a specific vowels that you need to practice on. So sometimes I remember my teachers will be nodding. Like they were really strict, and that's good when you're learning a language. And we do it in a fun and very empathetic way. That's one thing that we have at Beboop, where our teachers are very compassionate. So they'll see until what they can push you to get better at a specific word and things like that.
I love that. And yes, I even noticed just going on the website, like a little message popped up and it told, don't be afraid if you make mistakes. If a teacher calls on you, you can just say beep boop and it's fine. It's stress free. So could definitely see the empathy even from just going into the website. So I love that, one of the philosophies of the company. And then also being equitable, I really appreciate that. Audio only, so it's more accessible to people around the world, like you mentioned. And then also there's a version that's free, so that's really good, so anybody could join. So I wanted to ask you about that. So those values are really core values of your company. So can you please talk a little bit about the importance of creating an inclusive and diverse working environment? And then how has this app changed the way you look at those things? And why do you believe that language learning is such an important tool to achieve this equity?
Absolutely. So that's a really good question. First of all, it is really important for us to create an inclusive and diverse working environment, because we are aware that we are stronger in diversity. We're stronger when we have more points of views, when we have different languages. Like learning a new language is not just a door for you to say certain phrases. It's a door for you to learn about the culture, learn about their costumes, their traditions. A language is it's a window into another world that you can get access from the comfort of your couch. So you're learning Spanish, but you're not only learning these phrases, you're also learning about why they use certain words for describing this action, or why they use certain words like, and for example, we had a fun activity, like all the different meanings that pedo has in Mexican Spanish. And we didn't know that before. So we teach you at people all the real life words that you're going to use. And then we do that because we realize that sometimes these textbooks will give you a very outdated way of learning languages, and we will teach you the real hands-on language that you're going to use and that you're going to hear. So it's all about inclusivity and diversity. And then when we talk about healthcare and why we choose healthcare as one of our first products, it's because we realize that I'm a Latina. I'm also an immigrant here in the U.S. And I saw how my friends or family members, they were sometimes scared of going to the doctors. Like, they'll be like, oh, they don't speak Spanish, so I don't want to go. Or it took them a long time to find Spanish-speaking doctors because they feel more comfortable. They share little things that can tell you so much about their health, like their habits, what they usually do, their routines. And now with the pandemic, the Hispanic community has been disproportionately affected. And you can see that on the numbers. Like, we have Google Alerts, our emails, and we see every day a new news about how Hispanic Latinos in the U.S. are having higher numbers of getting COVID-19, how they're disproportionately affected, how now with the resource constrained world that we live in, sometimes healthcare professionals don't have a lot of time to spend on these patients. And then maybe because of the language barrier, they don't realize that there's so many little things that could be happening in the back they could take into consideration when creating a description of the patient. And it's insane. So we were like, you know, we're tired of reading those news because we wanted to do something. And that's why we did people like we started last year with healthcare, and now we're offering these classes for free to any healthcare professional. And we also have COVID-19 relief. So for patients that are, we teach healthcare professionals how to talk about COVID-19 prevention. We talk about how to do recovery of COVID-19 and talk to the family members about what to do with these patients that are living in the ER, the ICU unit, and then going back to their houses, what are the precautions that they need to take? So it's really important for us. So as I said, we are creating this environment of equity, inclusion, and diversity, because it's not just about diversity. You need to make sure that it's included. And then it's not about equality, it's about equity. And this is really important. During the fall, we were part of this healthcare entrepreneurship community challenge that we won an award from. And we learned a lot there about all of these different inequalities that certain communities in the U.S. have to face when going into a healthcare facility. And it's out there. Like, you can read so many papers. Right now, at the moment, we are updating our survey to healthcare professionals about how they're treating Spanish-speaking patients. And we're going to be showing the results soon on a blog post. And we're going to be showing it also in an article on LinkedIn, because it is there. Like, we just need a little bit more visibility on that, and that we are showing now that we are doing something to have an impact, which is also something really important for us, to have an impact in the problems that we're trying to solve.
That's so true, because it's not enough just like talking about it and being educated, but also taking action. So I'm just so happy that the Beep Boop exists, because those issues are there. And that, like you said, the pandemic has really brought them to light. And I'm really interested to hear, I know you said that equality and equity are different. So I wanted to hear your perspective on what you think is true equity, and what we should do to be sure that all of our organizations and all of our like health facilities and education programs are equitable.
Absolutely. I think this is really important for anyone that's listening that's interested in creating their own company. Mm-hmm. It's always to remember what's the culture of the company, what are the values of your company. And maybe when you're starting, you might think, oh, this is not really important at the beginning. It is, because what do you do? What do you share with your employees, your interns, with people that are working with you? At the beginning, it's going to stay with them, and you need to all the step of the way. So for example, I'll tell you, every introduction that we have, so orientations that we have with our new employees or new interns, we give them a talk about what are the values of the company, what is the vision of the company, the mission of the company, as well as the culture, who we are, how we interact. Because this is something really important that I've realized now that I'm running a company, is that companies are just an extension of their executive members. It will truly be like that. If you have people on the top that have these values in high states, and you'll see that it will go through all the layers of a company, like from tech, from engineering, marketing, PR, finance. It's really important that the people on top have these strong values and that share these ethos with the whole company. And that's something that tied it up to my experience with ILO-LA Global when I was doing my undergraduate research paper for graduation in Taipei. I was working at this organization called Taiwan Institute for Sustainable Energy, and we were focusing on corporate sustainability, and it was a top-bottom approach. And I think that's really important for people to realize that if a message comes from the CEO, and it's written down in the, let's say, in the reports, the yearly reports and things like that, it's going to have a big impact in all the stages in the company. So yeah, we've been doing this in the beginning. Equality and equity is different because equality, and there's like a famous picture of two, like people trying to look over a fence. And there's people with different heights and you give them all a little box. That's equality. But then equity is making sure that the people who are taller and already can see past the fence, they don't receive one. The ones who are smaller and they can't see it, they are the ones who receive it. And I think it's a more efficient way of distributing resources to make sure that you analyze people's background, analyze people's also distinct features, cultures, and you use that to allocate resources.
That's so true. I know you talked a little bit already about the top-to-bottom experience that you experienced in Taipei and how that helped you in global. So I was curious to see if there are any other parts of the program that helped you in developing the app, and if you had a favorite memory from the program that stands out to you.
Yeah, I think one of the biggest things I would say that it has to do with diversity and also sustainability was my experience doing my internship in TAIS. It was great. One, I was working. I was the only foreigner there working, the only Spanish-speaking person. Working in Asia there was just that. It taught me a lot about resilience as well as like adjusting to different corporate settings. I learned a lot about discipline. That's one thing that I'll tell every LA Global student. You are going to learn so much about how to manage very fast-paced environments and learning how to adjust to them in a very quickly manner. Because you're moving from one country to another country so fast that you don't really have time to think about, oh, let me adjust. Let me take a little bit of time to adjust. No, you will have to adjust in a moment that is really fast, but it will help you a long way. Because now with this is the thing, when you're running a tech startup, things change so fast that sometimes it's really hard for you to take that extra time to make sure that you're adjusting to the changes. It's a very fast-paced environment. Tech is changing constantly. There's so many events happening. There's so many things. For example, when you're creating an app, like my co-founder is working more with the technical side and he's working on UI and UX design, and it completely changes with feedback as time goes by.
Right.
And the same thing with LAU Global. It taught me, like, I remember that in Taipei doing my internship. Then also, when I was living in Hangzhou, I was able during the summer to take an apprenticeship, a training at my economic and commercial office of Peru in Shanghai. And I was able to also learn how to create more opportunities for foreign companies to enter the Asian market, specifically Chinese market, and just like learning how we were doing partnerships with corporations such as Alibaba, with buyers from Shanghai, from Hong Kong, and things like that. And LAU Global was an amazing opportunity. It gives you a bigger picture of how the world works, and it's going to give you an added value when you enter the work environment, the work market. You're going to go there prepared with all these tools and all these languages that you're going to be taught, and the connections that you make are really important to, like, when I was in LA Global, like I told you, I made sure that almost every weekend I was going to a networking event or to a workshop. I remember vividly leaving classes in Hangzhou and Zhejiang Dashui and then taking the train with my heels, my coat, my little purse, and just like going to Shanghai for an event for the night. I remember just like going into the train and being like, Bo hai su, like, I'm sorry, like, trying to get on the train because I knew I was late. So, it taught me to go after the things that I want. It taught me to have that decision, to have that independence. Like, LAU Global gives you this framework, but it's up to you also to make the best out of it. And yeah, it's, if you're interested in business, if you're interested in policy, if you're interested in international relations, there's something for you there.
I love that. And that's really, really good advice. That is awesome how you like took it into your own hands to just enhance the experience given to you, but also like expand on it. Like, that's incredible. And on that note, I wanted to see if you had any specific advice to students in the program, like right now, who want to venture into entrepreneurship specifically, and then also to students who might want to venture into language learning and be language teachers, if you had any advice for them.
What advice I'll give to people in the program is to, like I said, take advantage of these amazing opportunities of living in these amazing places and getting exposure to their community thanks to LA Bubble and this amazing stuff. Like, talk to your teachers, talk to your local teachers, ask them, tell them about what you're interested in. And I think this is really important, something that I've learned now. You have to socialize your ideas. What I mean by this is that you have to tell people what you're interested in. When someone meets you, they need to know from the get-go, what is the career that you have ambitions in? Like, what are your passions? What are your, outside of school, like, what are the things that you want to do after you graduate? And that will help you to create networks of people around the world that know already, like, if they come up with an idea or like an opportunity and they're like, oh, who should I talk to? Oh, I remember this student told me that they're interested in business. Or I remember that their student was interested in policy or nonprofit organizations. And then people that are interested in entrepreneurship, I would say, you guys are going to all these amazing countries. You should make sure, like I said, every weekend or after classes, like, you can do it. Like, make sure that you check the local scene of entrepreneurship. I will tell you that every country that I've been to, I was able to participate in the entrepreneurship ecosystems. I was going to network events. I was going to workshop events. I was going to conferences. Use your time wisely, because these opportunities are not out there for everyone. And then when you're trying to lean into language learning, I would say that take advantage of the language classes that you take. Make sure, like, you don't forget about it. Don't stay in your cocoon and just venture into the countries that you're in. You're going to learn useful phrases, and even phrases that you might not learn in school. Like, you'll learn the actual words that locals use to describe certain objects, actions, or feelings. And then if you're we're going to be expanding also our classes and hours. So in the future, when with people, when we start adding other languages, like, reach out. Like, the thing about people that's amazing is that anyone can be a teacher, mostly because our method and our platform makes it really easy for teachers to teach a foreign language. We have developed also teacher side of the platform, as well as the student side of the platform and the teacher side. It's amazing. Like, we're going to be launching these products in our social media soon. And it's really easy. You can become a language teacher just by knowing your native language. And yeah, that will be one advice that I'll give.
I was just going to say that I'm so glad that you brought that up of perhaps adding more languages. I was wondering which ones you think you might be able to add in the future.
Right now, our line would be, the next thing that we're going to be focusing on is on the next languages will be probably Portuguese. English is the biggest market that we have in overview. Because, as you know, a lot of people around the world are all about, I want to learn English to get opportunities. And what we teach you is speaking, which is one of the things, like, you'll meet a lot of, like, friends while you're traveling that they're telling you they're learning English and they don't want to talk to you in English because they feel not confident or they feel shy. With people, we are all about making you get that confidence, and we're all about leading you through these activities in which you feel comfortable after a while taking our classes that you're going to be able to talk. So that's like Portuguese, English, French. Eventually, we want to teach also Mandarin, but the next steps are launching, making our app public, and then seeing how we can always iterate. That's one thing that I will tell everyone about tech, is that it's always changing. It's always improving. And what we do at People that's really important is that we really value feedback. Everything that we do, we receive feedback from our teachers. We receive feedback from our students, from our paid students, our free students. It's all about feedback. That's very also instated in the culture of the company.
Talking about the teachers that currently are teaching in the program, I was kind of wondering, like, about their backgrounds. Are they all native speakers, or how do you find teachers to teach at Beepoop?
About 99% of our teachers are women. So that's something that we're really proud of. There are all of them based in Latin America. They're all native speakers. We have teachers from Mexico, from Colombia, from Peru, and then thing that we had, the first cohort of teachers that we recruited were also Ivy League educated, so they were part of this language training at Dartmouth College. But yeah, like our hope is that in the future, even monolinguals can become language teachers. Like I said, it's because of our platform and the method that we have developed. It makes it really easy for anyone to become a teacher. Another thing that I can tell about our teachers, where they're very compassionate. They're all about making you feel comfortable. It's a safe space. You join these classes. It's audio only, so you don't have to feel scared of like how you look, or like for safety reasons, like you're a woman, like you don't, sometimes like you want to be in a space where you use just your voice. Teachers, they're amazing. Like they're the backbone of the company. They're so good at giving out the classes. They're charismatic. They're also really focused on you speaking the words correctly with the right pronunciation. So at Bibu, we're not going to let that R fly away. You're going to learn how to pronounce the R. You're going to learn how to pronounce different vowels. And then that's it. Like they're amazing. I'm super thankful to them. Shout out to all of them.
Nice. Oh, that makes me so happy to hear. That's just so wonderful, empowering women. And they're making such a big difference. And I love they're compassionate. We need compassionate teachers. So that is just, makes me so happy. You've talked a lot about how you always want to grow as a company, and feedback is super valuable, and tech is always changing. So I was wondering, what is the biggest lesson you've learned so far while developing Beep Boop that you hope to carry along to future projects or continuing with Beep Boop?
Because there's so many things I've learned. I would say one of the most important things is that growth mindset. I will take that with me everywhere. And this is also applying to what we're working on at the moment and just like the whole journey of Bibook. We're constantly learning. If you're not learning, you're not helping you, you're not helping Bibook, you're not helping the world. You have to always create that knowledge and develop your skills. Like I've learned how to do problem solving really fast in an agile way. Also to advocate for myself. I think Bibook has given me that. It's helped me drop that mission everywhere that I go. I'm always like, I like to share with people my experience that knowing another language can really have a huge impact in your life and the communities that you're in. I think it's going to expand your vision so much. With people, you can converse with other people. And what better way to establish connections than actually speaking to other human beings? Yeah, I would say growth mindset, resilience, leadership too. It's been amazing to have these internship programs, cohorts, as well as to teachers.
Yes, I so agree with you. I love that that's like your biggest takeaway, because I'm also a big believer in the growth mindset. So that is wonderful. I was wondering, in more of a general sense, I know that the world is facing many issues, especially this year, but it always has been. And Beep Boop is just a wonderful way to tackle a problem that was important to us in helping healthcare professionals be more accessible and helping people learn Spanish. But I was kind of wondering what you thought, like, everyday people can do day to day, like an action they could do to make the world a better place today.
I would say having compassion, having empathy. That's why at Beep Boop, that's one of our most important values, is because you can make the world a better place if you understand how the world is for other people apart from you and from your community, people like you. The more you learn about other people's perspectives and experiences, the more compassionate you'll be to individuals around the world, and you'll learn what they need. Like, that's something that we're taught a lot in LU Global. Like, don't ever assume what people need, just ask. And you ask when you have compassion, when you're actually interested in other people's experiences. And what better way to ask that in their native language? Like, when you speak to someone in their native language, you speak to their heart. It's not just their rational side, it's their heart and emotions. So you make it a better place by having compassion, taking a step forward, working, not feeling like it's, and that's something that's really important from LA Global that I learned, is that the world has a lot of global issues, but just need to focus on one. Make it your goal to just have one legacy and then work towards it every day of your life, and it's going to help you. I'm going to tell you, it's like a little motto that you have inside of you. Like every day you wake up and you're like, oh, this is the thing that I'm working towards. And that's like, for example, today we had every Friday we have a demo session in which we talk to all our team. And then we ask today, what would be your people legacy? And what will be your legacy? Something important that everyone can ask themselves, because at the end of the day, we're all going to leave this world, so we might as well make the most out of it and have the better impact that you can.
Yes, I so agree, and I love your takeaway of just saying that if when you speak to someone in their native language, you're speaking to their heart, because that is so true. It's just such a beautiful way to show compassion and empathy. So I just love that's like the core of Beep Boop's philosophy and your own personal philosophy. So that is just wonderful. Before we end, I would love if maybe you could share Beep Boop's web address and where people can go to their social media if they're interested in learning Spanish, just so people know.
The website is Beep Boop, so BEEP BOOP.US, and you'll see our little cloaca there, and then you can find us on Instagram as well as BEEP.US. You can also find us on LinkedIn at BEEP.US. We also have our YouTube channel, and if you're interested to, you can be part of our social learning group online, which is called Learn Spanish by Speaking, and it's a group by BEEP.US, in which we're building a community of Spanish-speaking students, in which we're building a community for students that want to get conversational skills in Spanish. And we share their content. We share also information about the new modules that we come up. So like I mentioned, you can join a class at beepboop.us every 30 minutes. They are free. You can just choose your proficiency level and your desired time slot and just take a class.
That's incredible. Thank you so much. It is very true. Every time I say Beep Boop, I can't help but smile. So thank you so much for all that helpful information.
Absolutely. Thank you for inviting me in. Have a great day.
Thank you so much for listening to our Going Global podcast. If you have any ideas for any upcoming episodes, make sure to DM our Instagram at LAU Global. See you next time.